fresh, fun. The Nightside on News Talk Radio, CJAD 800. Sitting in is Kelly Alexander.
You cannot deny the power of dance music, no matter who you are. When a good dance beat comes on, like this, Earth, Wind & Fire, September, your foot's going to be tapping, even if you do not want it to. And joining us on CJD is author James Arena, who has written a new book called Stars of 21st Century Dance Pop and EDM, which is actually the final book in a 5-book series that has covered the importance of dance music, starting with disco. Now, this has been quite the journey for James and quite the labor of love to put these 5 books together with regards to research and tracking down all of these artists and producers who really have, you know, provided the soundtrack to our lives when it comes to dance music for the last several decades. James, welcome to the Nightside on CJAD.
Well, thank you so much, Kelly. It's a great honor to be with you tonight.
So, James, you know, there haven't really been any published books specifically about dance music stars before. So why did you actually decide to write, you know, this series, and what did you want to accomplish with the 5 books?
Yeah, I think the lack of books about dance music is indicative of the limited prestige given to dance music going back to disco. I think it possibly goes back to the public being familiar with the songs that became hits in the genre, but not always recognizing the names of the artists, the musicians, and producers behind them. I think that's always been a problem for dance music. There have been exceptions like Donna Summer, Gloria Gaynor, Nile Rodgers, Quincy Jones, but overall I'd say dance music artists haven't been afforded the recognition they deserve for their artistry. So my goal was to create a book about, specifically the first one was about the women who pioneered disco in its early years, which was the book First Ladies of Disco. I felt it was important to continue to try to document the stories of as many artists as I could get over the years. So that led to my creation of Legends of Disco, Europe, Stars of 80s Dance Pop, Stars of 90s Dance Pop, and now my latest book, Stars of 21st Century Dance Pop and EDM.
So, you know, dance music in general has not been taken as seriously as other forms of music like, you know, rock or country. You know, I would say by a lot of people, by the media, and even I would think by members of the public. Why do you think that is? Why I always feel like dance is, like a dirty little secret.
That's a good way to put it. You know, from what I've experienced and gleaned from the artists I've spoken with, I think it may stem from two factors. I think in general, music that's fun, uplifting, and associated with our youth, and that includes dancing and clubbing for many of us in our younger days as well, it isn't something we often take too seriously. In the process, I think some of the musicianship and beauty of this music was overlooked and forgotten. I think the backlash of disco experienced in 1979 and 80, though I never believed the masses went out burning disco records, but I think that media coverage of that lingered in the air. And disco and dance music, its reputation as a legitimate art form was harmed by that, at least on some level. That backlash, I think, still exists today a little bit. I have spoken with what you might call disco, if you want to brand them as disco artists. They're still reluctant to be called that. And to me, that's unfortunate because you never hear of an artist wanting to distance themselves from, say, country or rock. And yet sometimes there's this problem with being called a disco artist. And I think that's unfortunate for dance music.
I think so, too, because, you know, I'm not going to hide it. I'm a huge fan of all dance, of disco, of the 90s dance music, of EDM, you know, in these years. And so it hurts me when I feel like these people who have produced, you know, so many happy memories, whether you're dancing at a club in your 20s or, you know, at a wedding or what have you, you know, for so many of us, it's good times. It's good music. It makes us feel good. So when they don't want to be announced, you know, I've interviewed several dance artists over the years, and a lot of them don't want to be introduced as such. Like you said, they just don't want that to happen because they feel like it's a dirty mark on them. Can you actually give us, though, a few names of people that you've spoken to and some of the songs they've produced just to give us, like, an idea?
Oh, sure. That's one of my favorite things to do. Let's see. Well, I've spoken with and interviewed for various books, Sister Sledge, Hathaway, Right Said Fred, Gloria Gaynor, Pete, the late Pete Burns from Dead or Alive, a wonderful man. It was such an honor to interview with him. Fat Morvan from Milli Vanilli, Franz Jolie from Canada, and Denis Lepage of Lyme, also another Canadian, Randy Jones of the Village People. The list goes on and on. Carol Douglas, Carol Williams, the ladies that sang as the backup for Chic, the Ritchie family. The list goes on and on. I think the total list is like over 160 artists
Wow.
have been featured in all of these books.
And James, what are you know, you let them speak for themselves. What did you find was the most surprising thing that they had to say, I guess, as an overall general gist?
There were a couple of things that struck me. I think sometimes how hard some of their lives were. You know, it's a familiar story of how many of these artists from the past were treated unfairly by record labels or they weren't themselves savvy to how business was being conducted. So a lot of them went through that. That not so much surprising, but it was kind of unsettling to hear some of the stories. But what I also can say across every decade is that these artists were dedicated to their fans and to raising people's spirits. They wanted to be singers, songwriters, composers, musicians, DJs. The burden of having to watch your back all the time was a challenge to them because they were artists. And I was also surprised, you know, I definitely want to say this, I was also surprised by how kindly they treated me in writing these books. I think many of these artists were thrilled, maybe even honored to some degree, that they were being remembered for their work in a book series, and that made me feel particularly inspired to get these books published.
Joining us on the Nightside tonight is author James Arena. He's written a series of five books that deals with dance, starting off with disco and, you know, talking about 80s pop and 90s pop and even now into 21st century EDM. And you can actually follow him on Twitter at James Arena now. You know, have you noticed a change in the personalities of artists who specialize in dance music over the decades? Like, do you find that these younger artists that we have now, like the Zeds of the world and even like the Calvin Harris, are they more accepting of what they do?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And that's probably the biggest change that I've seen over the course of the years of writing these books and looking at the different decades. I think younger artists today are, let's look at it this way. Dance music today is pop music. I mean, most of the songs that are big hits are always remixed or originally in a dance music format. So dance is pop today, and so they have absolutely no reason to not embrace the format. They didn't have to pay so many dues, I think, as some of these artists in the past, or they're not as challenged by the reputation of past dance music. So I think the EDM artists and just dance music in general is far easier to embrace than it was perhaps in the past.
Can you tell us some of the cool things that have happened as a result of writing these books? Because again, I don't think anybody else has done what you've done, which is focus on dance music, over the decades.
Oh, thanks, Kelly. You know, it really was such a thrill and an honor for me to speak to people like Amy Stewart of Knock on Wood, Gloria Gaynor of I Will Survive, Sister Sledge, Franz Jolie, as we said. But, you know, speaking to these artists for me was an enormous thrill, and I will never, ever forget these experiences with them. But one thing that really, really stands out for me is the fact that from the very first book, First Ladies of Disco, a show evolved called First Ladies of Disco, and that features Evelyn Champagne King of Shame fame, Linda Clifford of Runaway Love, and the legendary Martha Wash, who worked with Sylvester through the Weather Girls and It's Raining Men and into the 90s with CNC Music Factory, Everybody Dance Now. So this group came together with our manager, James Washington, and we've kind of all formed this team for this show. We're going to be appearing at B.B. King's in New York next week on Thursday, July 19th. And you know, the show is really taking off, and it is such an exciting show. And these women are the cream of the crop. Boy, they perform so vibrantly, so with such excitement that the audience is on its feet the entire show. To see the book create that kind of energy has been hugely satisfying for me, and that's definitely been a highlight.
Now, where can people get their hands on these books, these five books, James?
Yeah, you know, the problem with my books is the titles are so long that nobody's ever going to remember them. So your best bet is to go on Amazon, go anywhere you purchase books. You can get them on in book format or in ebook format, Amazon, wherever you go. And just look up my name, James Arena, A-R-E-N-A. And if you want to attach the word disco or dance to that, you could do that. All the books will show up. I encourage every one of your listeners to give them a chance. Read the stories of these men and women who have contributed so much to making the world a better place and a more enjoyable place. And for all the incredible work they've done for lifting our spirits, I think their stories need to be heard. And I'm happy that I got the opportunity to tell some of them.
James, thank you so much for this. You know, I'm a big fan of your work. I think it's fantastic that you're spreading the word about dance music and letting people realize it is an amazing genre of music, and we should celebrate it. So thank you so much.
Oh, thank you, Kelly. What would I do without you?
I'm not sure, but we won't find out. That is James Arena, author of Stars of 21st Century Dance Pop and EDM. And again, you can follow him on Twitter at James Arena. Now, you are listening to The Night Side on CJAD.